Okay, as you can see, it's already dark, but it's set at the 7-inch, well, 7 1/4. Took a little break there. Not going to melt any more copper because that's melted the pipe or that copper. But as you can see, I want to show you something here. See these little pock marks here, here, and here? 3 hot spots. They're 1 inch, 1 inch, and 1 inch. So as we were testing, it was actually creating a beginning to melt the Joe pipe, the steel, the stainless steel. So we should expect to see more of these melting points. All right, let's turn on the power. There's a low. Turn on the propane. Trying for best resonant response. There we go, we have light. Air's on low, turning down the propane to level 2. Level 2, is it going to go in by itself? Pipe is kind of cold, so turning down just a bit more. Nice shift into level 3. Yeah, some old trail of copper melted inside, probably maybe 1/4 ounce of copper. But we are getting the extended flame inside. See if I can bring it out in the air over here. Show you something here. From the last test, I believe the extended flames have melted a pattern within the pipe. What I'm seeing is the evidence where the extended blue flame actually imprinted the inside of the pipe. I thought it was the flame pattern itself, but it looks like an imprint of the flame. So you know it's getting pretty hot. Okay, to the top right, that's not a flame, that's the imprint of the previous test. I don't see it oscillating at all. Crank it up. That's on full. We'll turn the propane down to about half. There. Way more than what you need. the barrel. From 3 feet away, it's like being in Florida. Two and a half feet away from the camera.